Hi, today we're going to learn about Elijah Lovejoy, who was assassinated for the freedom of slaves.
Who was Elijah Parish Lovejoy? He was born on November 8, 1802. He was an American Presbyterian miniature journalist, newspaper editor, and abolitionist. He graduated from Waterville College. He had a wife and two children.
Moving to Alton, Illinois, is it a good idea? Lovejoy and his family moved to Alton, Illinois after his printing press got destroyed for the third time in St. Louis, Missouri, which is a slave state, in 1836. But despite being a free state, Alton, Illinois was a place for slave catchers to capture runaway slaves. The citizens of Alton were unhappy with Lovejoy's views on slavery because they thought that harboring an abolitionist was bad for the economy, so really it was a bad idea to move to Alton, Illinois. On October 26, more than a week before the assassination, Lovejoy held a convention at a church to discuss the formation of an anti-slavery group, as you can see in the picture to the left, which is not the actual picture of the convention. But at the meeting, the Lovejoy supporters saw two pro-slavery advocates in the crowd, but they didn't kick him out even though they wanted to because the meeting was open to all parties. On November 7, 1837, the night of the assassination, a drunken mob came to a warehouse where the abolitionist press and materials were at and tried to set the building on fire. Trying to defend his news press, Lovejoy was shot and killed while one of his supporters, Royal Weller, was wounded. The mob then took the printing press and destroyed it.
No one was convicted of the crime. The jury foreman was part of the mob, while the judge was a witness. No funeral service was held, but many newspapers report of Lovejoy's death except for his own. No Illinois official spoke out against the crime, except for Abraham Lincoln, who mentioned him in his 1836 Lyceum address about the dangers of slavery.
Honors. His brothers, Owen, who became the leader of the Illinois abolitionists, and Joseph Lovejoy wrote a memoir about their murdered brother. The Elijah P. Lovejoy Monument was created in 1897, which was after the Civil War. It was placed in a cemetery that Lovejoy was born in, and you can see the monument in the picture to the left. Before 1860, Lovejoy's grave was unmarked until a man named Thomas Dimmock located and made a proper grave mark. Some of Lovejoy's supporters were later buried near or next to him.